Here's the homework part. Help part three. This is the improper fraction and mixed number worksheet. It says 9.9 at the top. At the bottom, there's 7 through 10, and you have to change the mixed number into an improper fraction. And in the past, some kids have built those little animated PowerPoints that explain how they work. So let's just watch some videos and see how it works. Okay, so this 4 went to here, and the 1 here goes here. And what happens is we're going to throw this 2, it's going to go through it like a machine, and then when it comes out, it's going to be 4 times 2, which is 8. Now it's going to go into the next machine, it's also spin, but 8 plus 1 is 9. Now this number becomes the numerator, it's on top. Now the denominator stays exactly the same. Really, if you look at it, you go 4 times 2 is 8, plus 1 is 9, and I go straight over here. It's super easy. The denominator stays the same. It's still number 1. That's where this goes. Numerator's going there. Numerator's going there. 3's going to go in there. This one doesn't shake around. 2 times 3. 3 went inside this box. It comes as 6. There we go. Now the 6 is going to slide into this box and get 1 added to it. Comes out as a 7. So that is the numerator, 7. The denominator stays the same, 7 times. And again, you can do it really simply by doing this. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7. 7 times. Okay, here's a good one. A little bit easier. Five flies in. 5 times 1. 5 comes out. 5 goes into the next box. 5 plus 4. 9. 9 is the numerator. 5 stays the denominator. Okay. I think if you're getting used to this, you can kind of do this in your head. 3 times 4 is 12, plus 3 is 15. The answer is going to be 15 for us. Let's go ahead and win the fun program. These 3 move to here because it's the whole number, and we're adding that. The 4 slides in. 4 times 3 is 12. Let's go into the. Oh, you can still kind of peek and maybe it gets there. 12 plus 3 is 15. And where does the denominator come from? It stays the same. Okay, this is for 11 through 14. We're going to change this improper fraction to a mixed number. And what we're going to do is divide the numerator by the denominator. And you're used to seeing it look something like this. And you can kind of tell what the answer is going to be. What's 14 divided by 3? Let me think for just a second. That's 4 times 3 is 12. And where's the 12 going? I just got finished with long division. Okay, so now normally you would do this. You would do 4 remainder 2. But this is how you report it as a fraction. It's 4 remainder 2, or the 2 goes up there, like this. And then you're not done with this 3 yet. Watch what we can do with the 3. The 3 becomes the denominator. Okay, so here's the next one. We're going to go 9 divided by 4. Okay, think about how many times 4 will go into 9. 2 times. 4 times 2 is 8. Minus 8 is 1. So we used to say 2 remainder 1. We're going to report it as a fraction. Watch. Can you guess what the fraction is going to be? So the divisor becomes the denominator. Okay, 8 fifths. Times 1 is 5, so 5 goes into 8 one time. So normally we say 1 remainder 3, but we're going to put it as a fraction. So 1 remainder 3, where does the denominator come from? Right here. Oh, we did that. Did we do that twice? Did we do 7/4? There we go. We did this one. 7/4. Okay, so there's 7 divided by 4 to make it your whole number. 1 times 4 is 4. Lots of times you say 1 remainder 3. We're reporting as a fraction. And we're changing an improper fraction to a mixed number. It's going to go up there, and where does our denominator come from?